odd you're here, Detective. Sitting all alone in a place like this. I'd never live it down if the papers got wind of it.
Hey. Ruth, right?
Oh, don't pretend you don't know. I'm sure you have a whole file on me by now, Detective. I suppose we weren't formally introduced. I'm Ruth Talon. Miss Ruth Talon, in case you're wondering.
Edward Carnby.
Enchanté.
Are you sure?
I had too many already.
Nice. It's good.
I know. I have great taste, Detective. I heard you're trying to break Jeremy's promise to the dark man.
Yeah. Do you know anything about that kind of stuff?
No. But it makes you wonder. If he made a promise, can't he simply stand by his words?
Look, I'm just trying to get Jeremy out of a bad deal, so he'll come back with us to New Orleans.
Well, if all fails...
What are you doing?
It's a sign of submission to the dark man. I saw it in a dream once.
What? You don't know the Prext Shipping Company by any chance?
I do. They made big money during the war. Their waterfront office is just over there.
How did you do that?
Do what, Detective? Bonne chance.
Hey, have you seen Emily Hartwood anywhere?
Are you trying to make me jealous, Detective? No, I haven't seen your doll anywhere.
Shipping Company. According to the book in Tarawea, the Dark Man is connected to a performance that Jeremy went to somewhere in New Orleans. I'm sure I can find the address inside.
It's locked from the other side. The sewer system has a tunnel running right below Craig's Shipping Company. I bet I can use it to get inside.
Thank you.
No way I can get this out of the way with my bare hands. But if I get that crane going, that should do it.
Thank you.
made it inside the warehouse. The office must be upstairs. Hey, I always wanted to try one of these.
The ship was raided while in dock. All of his things were recovered, but blood was shed. Several men were carried into the Mississippi River and drowned by ones who live in the deep. All items have now been signed and delivered. Now best keep the papers safe. What is left? Later is right, and hell is back again. Cargo Manifesto, September 19th, 1892. Breck Shipping Company delivered 4 steamer trunks, 1 Egyptian sarcophagus, and a large wooden crate belonging to the showman called the Black Pharaoh, performing at 18th Street.
Like the fog cleared up. You want to tell me what this is all about?
Welcome, detective, to the greatest show this side of the Mississippi. Nyarlathotep, the Black Pharaoh, the ancient magician who lived 1,000 lives and wore 1,000 masks.
I can see why you settled on calling him the Dark Man. Saves your breath. So you got scared by a stage magician, and now he's living inside your head.
You can mock me, detective. You would be the crazy one to think his presence can be ignored. Look where we are!
We didn't get to finish our last conversation, did we? You were about to tell me how to break the contract with the Dark Man.
No, we can't. We would turn loose on the world. So many innocent would die.
But there is a way to break out of the deal.
There is. He offered me a way out. Steps to take.
What are they?
You'll never find them. They're forever entombed in his sunken desert temple.
Jeremy, I'm not your enemy. Tell me where to go. How do I find the temple?
No, we can't. I have to make this sacrifice.
God damn it, Jeremy. I'm gonna save you. Don't worry. How do you save someone who doesn't want to be saved? Well, he's gonna get saved no matter what. I just need to find that temple somehow.
The address.
Oh. Sunken desert temple. I better get down there. Here we go.
The Dark Man's temple was buried beneath the sand. A cursed and dark place. Every step felt ill-considered. Carnby needed to find the contract that Jeremy signed with the Dark Man and get the hell out of here before he went completely mad.